So if tennis is important to God, it's so appropriate that we pray together and ask a blessing. Let us join our hearts and minds in prayer. Gracious God, our Heavenly Father, how wonderful it is to come together, knowing that you have ordained us to live and breathe and have meaning in life. We just thank you, Lord, that we have the privilege to be here tonight, to be healthy, to be able to be out. God, we just pray that you will bless now our evening of entertainment, of food, of activity. We ask a special blessing, Lord, on the food that has been prepared and on the hands that have prepared that. And we just thank you and ask your blessing in Jesus' name. Amen.
This is the crowd here for the chicken feed. It's a full house.
Well, we were able to find the unoriginal chicken. Now, he's going to come out here and, like I said, warm you up. Of course, he can't talk. He'll do it with gestures. He'll ask you to do various things. He probably wants you on your feet. He's probably going to teach you a dance or two. Please humor him. Please humor him because he's tremendously depressed. He has sat backstage and watched you eat about 350 of his friends. So here he is, the unoriginal chicken.
Thank you.
carrying essential vitamins to every part of your body. If you are tired because of iron poor blood, Geritol will make you stronger fast. Well, maybe not that fast, but fast. Our show tonight is called the Unoriginal Amateur Hour. The original Amateur Hour began on radio in 1934 as the Major Bowes Amateur Hour. In 1948, after Major Bowes passed away, Ted Mack revived the show on the Dumont Television Network. That set the stage for following shows such as The Gong Show, Talent Search, American Idol, and America's Got Talent. Some of the singers that went on to show business careers that were winners in the talent show were singers such as Gladys Knight, Ann Margaret, Pat Boone, Teresa Brewer. I guess that's about all. Unfortunately, we were not able to hire Ted Mack as your host tonight. The treasurer for the tennis club would not approve the $100,000 contract that Mr. Mack required. However, we were able to hire his cousin at a much lower price, I might add. This man needs a lot of introduction. Well, we don't have time for that. This is the most misinformed, misunderstood, and misplaced man on the face of the earth. Let's give a big carriage manner welcome to the black sheep of the Mack family, Thaddeus P. Mack. Please be seated. Please be seated. That's enough, please. Good evening, folks. You know, we have brought you the show here tonight. I think you're going to enjoy. We have spent the last year going all over the United States and Canada trying to find performers that you would enjoy. And we've assembled a great talent here tonight. We're going to start off tonight with Pat Boone's original hit. The original hit. Please, do not. Later. Pat Boone's original hit, Speedy Gonzales. Give him a big hand here.
Suddenly, I heard the plaintive cry of a young Mexican girl.
With a juicy big boat, come on board with your
What's that mean? Oh my gosh. Oh, we didn't rehearse this. On our back bows. Oh yeah.
So I'll just live my life. memories of yesterday. Thank you, folks. It's here for my backup.
Were you with me on a layover a week ago?
Hey, you just came here. What's going on here? You got a show going on.
Excuse me.
Yeah.
Have you ever at the Schenectady?
I've never been to Schenectady.
Neither was I. Must have been a couple other guys. Well, anyway, do you mind if I join?
I've seen this face someplace.
Oh, yeah, I think I have. I think I've seen that place. Someplace else.
No. My face is mostly right here, right on top of my neck. You know, I'm very famous, though. You probably saw me on television.
No. I've never been on television. Do you mind if I join you for a little bit?
I think you already have.
I just stopped in for a little drink to settle my nerves before I go to work. Airline pilot.
An airline pilot? Well, how in the world did you ever get to be an airline pilot?
Well, I used to be a bus driver, but I quit. Too many drunks on the road out there.
Sir, what do you fly?
I fly one of those big gray metal things with the things on the side.
You talking about the wings?
Are you an airline pilot, dude?
Well, tell me, sir, since you're a pilot, have you ever had any close calls?
Oh, yeah. Especially since they moved the men's room to the back of the plane.
Well, you know, sir, I was flying once and we flew from Los Angeles to New York and we actually lost an engine in flight.
Oh, that's all right. It'll turn up.
I hope so.
Yeah. You know, there's a lot of pressure on a pilot flying way up there, high above the, way up there above all them white.
The clouds?
You sure you're not an airline pilot? You know, it's quite sober in thought. Yeah, sober in thought and an inspiring feeling to know that there are hundreds of people on my plane all depending on me and two a whole of riding all in the palm of my hand.
That is scary.
Uh-oh.
What's the matter now?
I gotta get to the airport. I'm flying a
747?
You sure you're not flying? I'm flying a 747 to London tonight, and it leaves in precisely 1 hour and 43 minutes ago. I'll see you.
I have no idea where the hell they came from. You never know who's going to pop up here on the stage. You know, before I was interrupted by the pilot, we have a group here that is pure vocal talent. There's no instruments. There's no sound effects. They are the retired Boca Nons and the Misfits, so give them a big welcome.
She's just little Rosemont on Texas Avenue. While I love a good snare drum, I feel that volume-wise, it's just a little bit too much what you're doing there. See? Feel me? I didn't try and hold it down, will you? I appreciate it. Wherever I overhand, appreciate it. Whether I overhand, slow in the next sorry skirt, that's better. She walks along the river. I'm quiet, oh, that's so much better. I know that she remembered when they parted long ago. You know that there's just a world of difference. Mercy.
She's sweet as little Rosa, the Texas sailor. Her eyes are bright as diamonds.
Hey, Andrew, yuck, look at it. That's pretty. Oh, now I'm going, that's pretty. Formal art is full of gold. We'll do the flames together. We did so long ago. We'll play the banjo gaily. She loves me. You ain't any kin to the slant drummer, are you? Come up yelling, you can cover up Rose, buddy, but don't you cover up Texas, or I'll stick your head through that cotton picking snare drum and secede from the band. So help me mature our room.
And the yellow rose of Texas will be mine forevermore.
Come along, snare, the record's over. Idiot, stop it. Stop it, I'm saying. Just stop it. I'm getting out of here! You ruined landing from the loveliest parts in the whole. Peace.
Templeton Saddle. If you come around later, I'll tell you what he does for a living. You'd never guess. You know, recently I was down in Nashville trying to find some love songs, some romantic love songs that we could use on the show. And you know, I had a hard time finding anything. In fact, let me give you an example of what I found. Just a few songs. I probably could come back with about 100, but here's about 4 or 5 of them, some of the songs they're writing now. But right now, you want the yogurt next, don't you? So just hold on. Hold on. One simple example would say. First, let's go in with the, continuing the country mood, let's go with Jesse the Yodeling Cowgirl. Jesse and her two boyfriends.
You know the labor of me.
As a fairy, brings
thoroughbreds. As I was saying, I've got these songs I want to talk to you about from Nashville. One of them was, if I can't be number one in your life, well then number two on you. I'll marry you tomorrow, but let's honeymoon tonight. How many times we use that line? Sorry I made you cry, but now your face is cleaner. Take me out to the cornfield, honey, and I'll kiss you between the ears. You know, Yvonne made me cut out about 10 of those, and I think you like them. She said it was going too long. So that's all. Oh, I got one political one. This suits everybody. This will be for Democrats and Republicans. The oil is all in Texas, but the dipsticks are in D.C. I got with Roger and we wrote our own romantic love song. So if I could get Roger out here now, we'd like to sing that song for you, and David also compliment.
Well, come on, boy.
Now during this song, it's very romantic. So if you want to reach over there and hold her hand, that is if she's your wife. That would be just fine. And also during the song, if you'd just like to kind of reach over there and put your arm around her, because I know you're going to be very romantic while this song is going on. Just reach over there and put your arm around her there, Tim, and look her in the eye and say, honey, this is from me to you.
Are you ready, Lord?
Okay, Roger.
Okay, here we go. You ask me if I love you, and if my love is true. Well, darling, if I was a rich man, here is what I'd do. I'd buy you a diamond ring and a new fur coat or two. If my nose would run on money, I'd blow it all on you. My nose running money, I'd blow it all on you. I'd buy you a Cadillac and a new Mercedes too. I'd build you a mansion up on that mountaintop. If my nose running money, but honey, it's not. Anytime you'd want it cash, well, all I'd have to do is sneeze. Honey, you'd win the lottery when I had a cold or flu. If it was blood and money,
no laugh,
I'd throw it all on you. It's a booger of a problem we've got. I wish my nose was running money, but it's not. Buy you a diamond ring and a new Mercedes too. It was running money, I'd throw it all on you.
One more time.
If my nose was running money, I'd throw it all on you.
Yes, we would.
Yes, sir, B.
Thank you, Roger and David. want you to get involved, so stand up, if you will, stand up, if you don't have to. You know, you stretch, it'll be a long night, you might go 2 hours. So stand up, stretch your legs, and help them out with their song, Welcome Willie and the Hand Jive. Willie and the Hand Jive, here we go, folks. Jumps out of bed and said, oh, honey, please don't be doing that. Please don't do that. She said, shut up. You're next. I'll wait. Our town scouts went down south to find this next room. Singing a man of constant sorrow, here's the Soggy Bottom Boys.
I'm
Very good. That one lady used to be the rhythm band. Three ladies escape from the national prison at night. And they go into the woods. And not far behind them is the police and the bloodhounds. So they decide to go in separate trees and go up and climb the top of the tree. So the first, the redhead, brunette, and blonde, because they don't wonder who they were. It takes me a while sometimes. So anyway, the redhead, she climbs up in the tree, and here comes the police and the guard dog, bloodhound, look up there, and she goes, she's thinking pretty fast, and so she goes, meow, meow. And the guard says, well, that's just nothing but an old kitten, an old stray cat. So they go to the next tree, and the brunette's up there, and she thinks pretty fast, and they're looking up there in the tree, and she goes, hoo, hoo. And the guard says, well, that's just nothing but an old owl up there in that tree. So they go to the third tree. There's the blonde up there, and she's thinking frantically what to do. And pretty soon she thinks, and she goes, moo. Out here. I mean, regular blondes. Okay, next we have, y'all like magic? I bet you didn't. We have a great magician here. He's turned all the world. His illusions are fantastic. And I want you to give a big welcome to the whodunit and his assistant, his beautiful assistant, Bunny. Give a big welcome again. Thank you.
bought into that. Great job, Boo.
He said, I want to buy a TV. He said, I don't sell the blondes.
So she goes home, dyes her hair red. She comes back, goes to the same store, tells the clerk she wants to buy a TV. He said, I don't sell blondes. So she goes home and dyes her hair brunette. Comes back, looks at the TV, she says, I want to buy a TV. The clerk says, I do not sell to blondes. Now she's upset. She said, I know that you like coming here as a redhead. I come in here as a brunette. How come you don't sell? And he says, because you're looking at a microwave. I came that close to screwing that joke up. But I recovered. Probably in the back, he said, oh, he didn't recover. The next young lady has a story to tell you. When she gets it off her chest, I'm sure she'll feel a lot better. Welcome, Yvonne, doing She's Got You. Thank you.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Tonight, this little song we're going to do has to do with an incident that happened in a small southern church in Mississippi. Anyway, we were kind of wondering how our own Pastor Mike Shealy would do here at Broadway Chapel if this same incident were to happen here. So anyway, with all the grandchildren visiting, who knows, maybe someday it will. So, have you folks ever seen anybody dress up formally before? Mm-hmm. Okay, so here we go. Well, when I was a kid, I used to take a trip every summer down to old Mississippi to visit my granny in her antebellum world. I'd run barefooted all day long, yeah, climbing trees and trees of the song. But then one day I caught myself a squirrel, yeah. Well, I pushed him down into an old shoebox and punched a couple of holes in the top, and when Sunday came, I stuck him into church, yeah. Well, sitting way back in the very last pew, showing him to my good buddy Hugh, and that squirrel got loose and went totally berserk. Well, what happened next is hard to tell. Some thought it was heaven, others thought it was hell. But the fact that something was among us was plain to see. As the choir sang, I surrender all. That squirrel ran a far through the coveralls and hard leaped to his feet and said, "Buddy, I'll hold on him." But hey, the squirrel went berserk in the first self-righteous church in that sleepy little town of Pascagoula. It was a fight for survival that broke out in revival. They were jumping pews and shouting, "Hallelujah!" Well, arm hit the aisles of dancing and screaming. Some thought he had religion, others thought he had a demon. The power thought he had a weed eater loose and hit us through the loom. Well, as he fell to his knees to bleed and beg, that squirrel ran out of his riches way to the other side of the room. Sat Sister Bertha, better than you. She's watching all the commotion with sadistic glee, yeah. Well, you should have seen the look in her eyes when that squirrel jumped her garters and crossed her thighs. She leaped to her feet and said, "Lord, have mercy on me," yeah. Well, as the squirrel made laps underneath her dress, she started to cry and then to confess to sins that would make a sailor voice with shame. Told of gossip and church dissension, but the thing that got the most attention, she talked about her love life, yeah, started naming pain, yeah. The day the squirrel went berserk in the first self-righteous church in that sleepy little town of Pascagoula. It was a fight for survival that broke out in revival. They were jumping pews and shouting, "Hallelujah." They were jumping pews and shouting, "Hallelujah."
Yeah.
Three blondes go into a bar. Yeah. And they go outside up to the bar, and the person orders a BL. And the bartender, been around a long time, he said, "Yeah, I think I know what a BL is. That's a Bud Light." She said, "Yeah, that's fine." The next blonde orders a CL. He thinks for a little bit, and sure enough, he comes up with a Coors Light. She says, that's correct. And the third blonde says she wants a 15. And he thinks and thinks and cannot think what a 15 is. And she looks at him, she says, "It's a 7 and 7, you silly thing." Big surprise coming up. I don't know what we got here. We got we got something in there. There's something wiggling. So it really looks suspicious to me. It is a surprise to all of us. Whoop. Sorry, we have no words for that. No words for the to give a funeral for the dog. So he goes to a Catholic church, sees the priest, and the priest says, no, we can't give Walter a funeral. We have no liturgy for that. So he goes to the Methodist church, and he gets the same thing. The minister said, no, we can't do that. And the gentleman says, well, can you recommend a church that might give Walter a funeral? You see, I was going to donate $500,000 to the church that would give Walter a funeral. And the preacher says, man, why didn't you say Walter was a Methodist? Pretty smart pastor. Let's change tempo now with a quartet singing the Diamond Song, Little Darling.
I'm the
next Friday night, February 26th. Tickets will go on sale Monday, February 22, from 9 in the morning till 12:30 noon out here on the patio by the grill. Also, they will be sold at the door Friday night. $5 per person, that's just the show, no dinner. Okay, we'll begin with our introduction of the cast and the crew. Larry Lou. Lloyd King. Donna Dahl. Jim Payne. Dave Erickson. Randy Swift. Levon Burns. Gail Miller. Sherman Dahl, Sophia McHugh, Cynthia Cheely, Mr. Bob Hooker, Lawrence Whitney, Carl Vinci, Rich Collier, Bill Wilson, Elaine Gray, Mary Cole, Lana Wilson, Patty Beauchamp, Mike Cheely, Marcy Rookie, Bo White, Mal Goodman, Polly Guglielmo, Roger Mower, Nancy Mower, Carol Bankston, Sonny Bankston, Mike Smith, Bonnie Bailey, Robert Mehta, Mark McHugh, Bill Adams, Rich Gold, Dick Brown, Ben Ulrich, Dale Nielsen, and Dale Aiden. Recording, Bob Hooker and Mark McHugh. Sound man in the back, Dick Sorensen. Videographer, Odell Bird. Photographer, Les Hunt. Set design, Barb Gadd. Poster, Sonia Medgard. Stage managers, Barb Gadd and Jane Sorensen. Stage hands, Larry Luke and Sherman Dahl. Costume design, Artie Luke, Sophia McHugh, and Carol Van Quaad. I'm not going any farther than you come out here. Props, Alex and Gail Miller, Gordy Hine and Bill Adams, announcer Ken Krakus, and lady here, and gentlemen, here's the lady that makes it all happen. She started about a year ago tomorrow, and you cannot believe the hours she puts in. Our director, Yvonne Gammon.
Thanks for coming, ladies and gentlemen. Drive carefully going home. It's raining.